Welcome to our discussion video for property, plant, and equipment under government accounting. So how do we account PPE when we are looking at government entities? So at the end of this discussion, we will be able to state the initial and subsequent measurements of items of PPE of government entities. We describe the following and state their peculiar accounting requirements. One is heritage assets, second infrastructure assets, and then reforestation projects. And then we account also for borrowing costs by a government entity. Okay, under our financial accounting and reporting, we know what property, plant, and equipment is. So we just have to review this. PPE are tangible assets. So these are the characteristics of the PPE. These are held for use in the production or supply of goods, services, or program outputs, for rental to others, or for administrative purposes, which are not intended. Please take note of this for the resale or in the ordinary course of business. Because if it is intended for resale in the ordinary course of business, it can be classified as an inventory, or if it is used as an investment activity, it can be classified as an investment property in our na diniscuss natin on our last lecture videos. Next is that it is expected to be used for more than one accounting period. And this one is the capitalization threshold of 15,000. So this is unique under government accounting dahil kapag 15,000 and above, yan ay classified as property, plant, and equipment. Pero kung yan ay tangible asset, it is held for use in the production, and it is expected to be used for more than one accounting period, but it does not comply with the capitalization threshold. For example, it amounts only to 14,000, hindi yan classified as PPE under government accounting, but it is classified as a semi-expendable inventory or semi-expendable property. So it will yun yung isang peculiarity when we look at government accounting, in the Philippine government accounting. So let's discuss this, yung capitalization threshold ng 15,000. So what does the 15,000 mean? This is the minimum cost an item should have before it is capitalized as a PPE. So kung yan ay 14, katulad nga sinabi ko kanina, it is classified as a semi-expendable property. Semi-expendable property. So meron na tayong discussion related to semi-expendable property in our previous discussion videos. Na yan ay nire-recognize as semi-expendable property, and then after a period, a month, yan ay tinatransfer na into semi-expendable expenses. At yung semi-expendable properties na yon ay merong document na that will evidence kung kanino siyang accountability through the inventory custodian slip, yung ICS natin. Okay, it is applied on a per item basis except when there are group of assets that work together and there are bulk acquisitions of small items of PPE. Anong sinasabi dito? Ang sinasabi lang dito on a per item basis ang pag-account mo sa kanya. For example, bumili ka ng photocopying machine, tingnan natin kung magkano ang cost, ang invoice cost nitong photocopying machine na ito. Okay? Ganun siya. However, there are cases na pag tiningnan mo siya on a per item basis, siya ay hindi siya papasok dun sa capitalization threshold na 15,000. But if you will analyze it, dapat siyang i-classify as PPE. Anong example na itong group of assets that work together? Ang normally dyan is yung mga IT equipment. Okay, anong mga klaseng IT equipment ang sinasabi natin under that? For example, yung mga hardware ng mga computer like web servers, router, modem, yan ay mga communication network na yan ay pag on a per item basis mo, hindi yan papasok under PPE. But these group of assets work together. So dapat ang appreciation mo dyan is as a group. So kung kapag kapag tiningnan natin or sinum up natin ang acquisition cost ng bawat item na yan ay lumagpas siya doon sa 15,000 threshold, then it is proper na i-recognize natin yan as a PPE under Information and Communication Technology Equipment account title. Okay? Next, if there are bulk acquisitions of small items of PPE, ang example naman dito, for example, is yung mga library books, computer peripherals, and small items of equipment. Na kapag tiningnan natin yung aggregate cost, it would be 15,000 and above. So, yan ang isang conditions. It is applied on a per item basis, except, tingnan mo kung yung group of assets na yun ay it work together, at tingnan mo kung ang acquisition natin is by bulk. Kasi kung by bulk yung acquisition natin dyan, pwede natin yan i-considered as a property, plant, and equipment. Okay? Next, the PPE is initially measured at cost. So, the initial measurement of cost comprise of the purchase price, the direct cost, and the present value of the commissioning and the restoration cost. The purchase price, we know that this will include the import duties, non-refundable purchase taxes, after deducting trade discounts and rebates. The direct cost, na palaging binabanggit when an item is initially measured at cost, these are directly attributable costs that are necessary in bringing the asset to the location and the condition for it to be capable in operating in the manner in which it is purchased. Okay? And next is the present value of the decommissioning and the restoration cost. Anong ibig sabihin nito? Yung decommissioning cost, this refer to the cost of dismantling or uninstalling a PPE at the end of its useful life. And the restoration cost refer to the cost of restoring the site where the PPE is previously installed. So, ibig sabihin, ngayon pa lang, tinitingnan na natin itong future decommissioning and restoration cost na ito. Kaya kinukuha natin yung present value niya para maisama natin doon sa cost ng asset na yun. Okay? Okay. The present value of this cost are capitalized as cost of the PPE and with the corresponding credit to a liability account other provisions. Kasi nga, i-set up natin yan as utang natin. Okay? But since ang tinitingnan natin dito is the measurement of the PPE, isasama po natin yung present value ng decommissioning and the restoration cost. Okay. Next, how do we get these types of PPE? So, there are several modes of acquisition. One, yung pinaka-basic is the acquisition by purchase. Bumili ka ng property, plant, and equipment, item of PPE. So, ito po ay classified as CO. Ano na yung CO? The capital outlays in the budget registry. So, doon natin kukunin yung pondo under the capital outlay. Okay? So, we have cash discounts. Cash discounts are excluded. So, ibig sabihin, lahat ng magiging discount mo on the purchase related to cash discounts, hindi natin yan isasama doon sa ating PPE item, doon sa amount na i-record mo on the initial measurement. When purchases are under installment basis, the cash price equivalent is used. So, kung halimbawang yan ay hindi binili through cash, yan ay under an installment basis, kuhanin po natin yung cash price equivalent. So normally ay naka-indicate doon sa problem yung cash price equivalent ng item na yun. The difference between the cash price and the installment price is amortized as interest expense over the credit term. So meron po tayong interest expense na nire-record when we are looking at purchase under installment basis. Next, the promotional items. Promotional items, these are items that are acquired in conjunction with the purchase of PPE. So, for example, bumili ka ng 10 computer and as a promotion, binigyan nila tayo ng isang item isang computer item. So, ano ang gagawin natin doon sa isang item na yun? Isasama ba natin siya on the capitalization of the cost? Or, i-recognize ba natin yun as gain? So, yun yung question dyan. So, there are two conditions under as provided by the government accounting manual. Sabi, if the promotional item is the same as that of purchase, yung total acquisition cost is allocated to all the items acquired, including the promotional item. Okay? So, for example, sampu yung binili mong computer, eh may isang promotional item or libre na computer. Therefore, dahil parehas naman silang computers, itotal mo po yung acquisition cost and then i-divide mo doon sa 11. Ang magiging denominator mo ay 11. Okay? Dahil pare-pareha sila. However, if the promotional item is different, halimbawa, 10 computer, tapos ang libre sa'yo ay isang table. 10 computer ang binili mo, pero may libreng table, ano ang gagawin mo doon sa costing noon? Isasama mo ba? Or what? Or recognize mo ba yun as gain? Or anong magiging denominator mo? So, ang sabi under the government accounting manual, if the promotional item is different from the other items acquired, in this case, computer at saka table, magkaiba yun, the initial cost of the promotional item is its fair value. So, kuhanin yung fair value ng table. The purchase price net of the fair value of the promotional item is allocated to the other assets acquired. So, therefore, ibabawas mo. So, kung ang value ng 10 computer ay ganitong amount, ibawas mo yung fair value ng table. Kasi kumbaga yun ay pangbawas doon sa cost, doon sa carrying amount ng binili mong 10 computer. Then, i-divide mo siya doon sa assets, doon sa 10 computer na binili mo. Under page 245, you will be looking at the same illustration. In this case, truck yung ginagawa niyang example. So, that is for your study. Let's look at the acquisition by construction. So, pwede ka rin magkaroon ng PPE kung ikaw ay magpapagawa. It's under, pwedeng ang construction mo is under a contract, under a construction contract, or under a self-construction, or construction by administration, or ikaw mismo yung gumawa. So, there are two conditions dyan. Okay. This is also classified as capital outlays in the budget registries. Okay. So, under acquisition by construction, gagamit po tayo ng construction in progress account, which is initially used as in recording the transactions. Kasi kapag construction, hindi naman agad yan natatapos normally within a year. So, kailangan natin gumamit ng account title such as this construction in progress. Or, kung kaya man yan within a year, kailangan pa rin natin gumamit ng construction in progress because this is mandated under the government accounting manual. Kasi kailangan nating i-record yung every time na magkakaroon ng billing sa'yo, kailangan i-record mo na yung construction in progress. Hindi naman pwede na 50% completion pa lang, naka-record, naka-book na kaagad, or naka-capitalize na ang iyong building. Kasi mag-automatic depreciate yan dun sa iyong electronic national government accounting system. So, kapag naka-CIP yan, hindi pa yan mag-generate ng depreciation. So, later on, we will discuss the mode of on how we depreciate assets of items of PPE. So, ang sinasabi under acquisition by construction is that it is classified as capital outlay in the budget registries, and then we use CIP or the construction in progress account in initially recording this. So, under construction contract, o kung ikaw ay humanap ng third party na magko-construct ng or na contractor that will construct a particular building or an item of PPE, ang sabi dyan, it is recognized as recorded. Yung value ng iyong PPE is at contract price. So, kung magkano yung contract price mo, yun po ang iyong amount ng iyong PPE. Kapag yan naman ay under self-construction or ikaw mismo ang gagawa, yung amounts ng direct materials, direct labor, and the construction overhead cost ang iyong amount ng PPE. Okay? you will be looking at items or yung illustration, scenario by scenario under page 247 and among others. So, ang I want to emphasize here, for example, let us look at illustration 1 under page 247. So, si Entity A nag-award siya ng contract for the construction of a building to Contractor Z. The contract price is 40 million. So, upon awarding the contract, Entity A requires a 4 million performance bond from the contractor. So, in government accounting po, hindi pwedeng mawala iyang performance bond na yan. Because this performance bond is a security on the part of the government na once na nagpirma ng kontrata yung outside contractor ay this performance bond will require them to really perform what is indicated in the contract. So kung halimbawa hindi sila tumuloy ay pwedeng ma-forfeit yung mga performance bond na yan. So for example, in this case, you recognize the receipt of performance bond from the contractor. You just have to debit cash collecting officer and then credit guarantee security deposits payable. So yan ay ibabalik mo sa kanya kapag nakumpleto na yung construction. So 4 million. Then, yan po ay i-remit mo sa treasury. So debit cash treasury agency deposit and then credit cash collecting 4 million. Okay? So, nasa National Treasury yung amounts na yun. So, on February 1 daw, Entity A makes a 15% advance payment to the contractor. So, advance payments are allowed as long as it is indicated in the contract. So, debit advances to contractor 6 million and then credit cash MDS regular 6 million. That is 15% of your 40 million. Okay, on July 31, ang bilis gumawa, meron na agad progress billing which reflects a 50% stage of completion. So, ibig sabihin, gawa na yung 50% ng iyong construction contract. So, so ikaw ay pinadala ng billing statement, ng statement of account ng contractor mo at naniningil na siya. So, how do you recognize this? Okay. Ang sabi, the account is initially used is the construction in progress. So, debit construction in progress, ang subsidiary ledger natin ay buildings and other structures. Kasi maraming subsidiary ledger yung CIP. It will depend kung anong klase yung pinagawa natin. So, 40 million times 50%, that is 20 million. Then, credit, advances to contractors. Yung 6 million po na in-advance mo kanina, kuhanin mo lang yung 50%. Kasi yan ay hindi mo agad ibabawas yung 6 million. Kasi yan is for the entire duration of the construction contract. Dahil 50, nakabase pa rin yan dun sa percentage of completion. So, 6 million times 50% is 3 million. And then, credit accounts payable, 17 million. That is to recognize your progress billing. Okay, on August 8, I am on page 248. On August 8 naman, halimbawa, the Entity A pays the progress billing. Kasi kanina, nirecognize mo pa lang yung liability. Diba? Ang debit, ang credit mo ay accounts payable. So ngayon, babayaran mo na siya on August 8. Pero, bago mo siya bayaran, kailangan mo computin muna yung it is provided in the government accounting manual. It is provided, should be on the contract. One is the retention. Meron pong 10% retention na sinasabi on the government accounting manual at yung withholding tax every payment of projects related to construction in progress. Okay. 10% retention computed on the billing net of the recoupment for the advances na kinikredit natin sa guarantee security deposits payable. So, how do you recognize this? You debit, accounts payable, 17 million, debit debit, kasi nga babayaran mo na, and then credit, guarantee security deposits payable, nilipat mo lang, 1.7 million, credit due to BIR, 1.2, credit cash MDS regular, 14.1 million. So, ang babayaran mo lang sa kanya is 14.1 million. Okay, sir, para saan po yung guarantee security and deposits payable? It is provided in the GUM, yung 10% retention. Para saan yun? Itong 10% retention na to, this is another control or security on the part of the government to assure na yung 50% na binabayaran mo. Kasi there is a possibility na merong errors in the construction. There is a possibility na baka hindi maganda yung trabaho. So, it is provided in the GAM na meron tayong 10% retention na habang ginagawa niya yung additional construction ay nakikita natin yung progress in the project. So kung meron tayong makitang damages, kung meron tayong makitang ginawa that is beyond or below our specifications, ay pwede nating i-charge doon sa retention na ibinawas natin. So pwede nating i-forfeit yung pagbayad nitong retention na to. So yun yung guarantee security deposits payable na tinutukoy dyan. So anong difference itong guarantee security deposits payable dun sa performance bond na in-indicate natin kanina? Yung kanina, although it is credited to guarantee security deposits payable, may subsidiary ledger sa loob noong guarantee security deposits payable na para sa performance bond at yung isa ay para sa retention. So kapag performance bond ang pinag-uusapan natin, this is a security on the part of the government to assure that the contractor will perform. While in the retention fund, this is a security on the part of the government that will ensure hindi na yung pag-perform eh, kasi nagpe-perform na talaga siya, that will ensure quality on the construction of a particular item of PPE. So yun yung isa sa controls under construction projects. Okay, next, on December 1 naman, naka-receive siya ng final billing. So since this is a final billing, you just have to debit again, construction in progress buildings and other structures, 20 million, credit advances to contractors, 3 million, and then accounts payable, 17 million. Okay, on NTTA charges the contractor 40,000 representing liquidated damages for the delayed completion. 40,000 representing liquidated damages for the delayed completion. Sir, paano nangyayari yung liquidated damages? Magbabasit po tayo doon sa construction contract. Naka-indicate doon kung kailan dapat matapos. So kung hindi yan natapos, kung kailan siya dapat merong letter of requesting for extension subject to the approval of the head of the agency. Pero kung wala, the automatic na kailangan natin mag-charge ng liquidated damages. Yan ay nagka-count for every day of delay. So, tingnan mo yung government accounting manual, i-control F mo, i-search mo yung liquidated damages or miscellaneous income, makikita mo doon. If I'm not mistaken, that is 1 over 10 of the amount of the 1 over 10 yung proration natin dyan. So, tingnan mo yung computation dyan. So, in this case, pin-provide na niya yung mismong liquidated damages amounting to 40,000. So, how do we recognize this? You debit cash collecting officer and then credit miscellaneous income to recognize the collection of liquidated damages. Okay. On December 8, the NTTA pays the final billing after 10% retention and 1.2, same lang doon sa ginawa natin kanina. Debit accounts payable, credit the guarantee security, credit due to bear, credit cash MDS regular. So since this is complete, 100% complete, kailangan na po nating i-reclassify yung asset from CIP to its proper account title, yung mismong PPE account title. You debit buildings, 40 million credit, construction in progress, buildings and other structures, 40 million. Okay. Then, we have, kung okay na tayo, based on the analysis of the engineering department, of the property division, so meron pong report na ibibigay yan na magsasabi that 100% completed at sumunod doon sa quality specified, so pwede na nating i-refund yung ating guarantee or security deposits payable. So debit, guarantee security deposits payable 7.4 million and then credit cash MDS regular 7.4 million. Okay? To recognize the return of the performance bond and the release of the retention. So please take note that in practice, ang sinasabi, kapag tayo ay nag-refund, dapat wala na tayong habol doon sa contractor. Kaya maingat dapat ang ating pag-analyze doon sa mga buildings. So normally, itong pag-refund ay hindi ganun kabilis. So although natapos na yung project, nagbibigay sila ng period a reasonable period for the engineering and the property division to really carefully evaluate yung natapos na construction para makita talaga natin kung nakakomply, hindi baka mamaya ginamitan ng substandard na construction materials and many other factors. So, hindi agad-agad yan dito sa ating illustration, ang bilis, di ba, na nirefund, pero in practice, hindi ganun kabilis. It will take sometime kasi ang tinitingnan nila diyan is yung durability nung na-construct na PPE. Okay. Okay, I think I have to end my discussion here and we will just continue on the next part for more of construction by administration naman tayo. Thank you.